各位上午好，跟大家分享一下联盟链新增新进展和公链新思维这样。
Good morning. I will talk about consortium and blockchain, consortium chain and public chain. ICO is a very hot topic. And so, for since the issuance of Hyperledger, it is not as hot as ICO. So this is the current situation. So based on it, we will make some analysis. Why is this such a case? So what is our next step? As for the global situation, mainly the three pillars, like Hyperledger Fabric, R3 Coda, and Ethereum Enterprise version. Among the three, for R3, this system, still receives different voices. Many people don't understand it very well or even misunderstand it. And also, it is very hard to understand because in itself it is obscure. Due to the time limit, I will not elaborate here today. As for R3, detailed analysis, I would skip it. For R3, it doesn't think Coda is a blockchain in traditional sense. Of course, we have different understandings about blockchain. If we make that everybody verifies it as a precondition, of course, R3 doesn't meet that. It has some core definitions. It has UTXO documents and also identity, as well as transaction. It's like a smart contract. Of course, it has its own graph with its evidence, and to verify the evidence together or make third party to verify the evidence. So actually, it further expand the UTXO definition. After verification, then there will be a new and efficient document.
The input and output status and those business logic and the trade and those difference of the nodes, we just try to make them in a clear way. Because between the input and output, there's some architecture which can support SQL access. And we have those inspection signature between three persons, three batches of persons, so it can reduce those awareness scope. So it can make those authentication to be prominent. Authentication is just like a related person. Because we have this node of authentication, and it's totally different than the other. A consortium blockchain's ways, including some of the ways adopted by the public blockchain, this authentication node also have four wants. All these four wants also cause your attention about the cybersecurity. But if it's a kind of deployed based on the consortium, all this have its business support. Its business features. First, it is status driven. For example, your letter of credit. It can carry out, for example, blind signature, those confidentiality protection. You can also intervene, be intervened with legal documents. For example, your community are all here speaking. Code is law. Codeless law. While the code can have some kind of bugs, then in this convocation, where the law is. So they introduced the legal documents to have the hashi, the legal documents to bind it together with that. Then let me talk about some of the our comments on it. First, we think that Corda is a current consortium blockchain's most closest neighbor to the bank from the those compliance privacy and the operation consideration compared with the other platform is more similar to the bank. Second is the weak global sustainable, or even it doesn't have the global system. It's just a local database globally. Which is first, which is second, doesn't have this judgment. For those weak global consistency, it's suitable for the bank business, but not suitable for the security business. For the security business, you need those kind of transparent regulation, and it needs some kind of global regulation. All this is not supported by it. And for its authentication node, frankly speaking, it's a kind of semi-centralized feature. So you can see this kind of witness, for example, dig the mine, this kind of mine is totally decentralization. If it's a CCP-based traditional, you can name it as an authentication node. Basically, it's centralized. While the authentication node is a kind of partially decentralized, definitely. For the operational and emergency privileges, if needed, in their framework, compared with others, it's much easier. It's a kind of matter with much easier to realize. For some emergency, for part of the business, we have to of the blockchain, we have to stop it. It's like this. There's some kind of comments. They spend so much money and created the blockchain. Is that really like this? We should say that absolutely it's not like this. There's a possibility maybe this project cannot be landed, but the reason of not landing, not definitely, is because of the technological issues. You know that in the past.